the midst of a renewal, of a refreshing, actually of a revolt. Okay? We don't want to get renewed and refreshed just to go home and sit down and do nothing. But I'm staging a revolt against the enemy right now.
Right now.
Right now. Listen, everybody in here, by virtue of the fact that you came on tonight, God is going to elevate you from a low place, and he's going to take you to a high place. Many of you have been yoked up just like an ox with a yoke about his neck. Can't go no way but the way the yoke is pulled. And some of you, you've been yoked up so long till you don't even know what it's like to be free from the yoke. Some of you have been carrying some heavy burdens, and they got you walking bent over, and you don't even know that you've been over because you've been like this so long until you think it's normal. But I want you to know that God said tonight that the burden is going to be removed from off of your neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. I want to tell you on today, based on the yoke and based on the burdens, you have been in a place where it's almost like the Euroclidean storm that Paul found himself in. And as a result, because you have heard so many things about the power of a Euroclidean storm, most people don't even think that a person that's been caught up in a Euroclidean storm, they don't expect them to make it. They think that that is the end of it all. Listen, God told me to tell you that you are going to make it through. Listen, say, I am going to make it through. Come on, stand up. Say, I declare. Not because I feel like it, but because God said so. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory. I love it. I hear the horn blow. Hey, that means power. There is a reason why God called this revival. There is a reason why God told me to tell each one of you that you're going to leave here refreshed. There is a reason why God told me to tell you that you're going to be renewed. And all of this old stuff that's been hanging on to you, it has no other choice but to drop off based on what's going to happen to you on this night. God said renewal, refreshing, uplifting, elevation. Hallelujah. Listen, why is all Oh, this is so important. I want each and every one of you to know many people have the erroneous idea that once you get saved, your troubles are over. Uh-oh. I want you to know that once you get saved, that's when your troubles really begin. Hey, because you've been put on the devil's hit list. And the closer you walk with God, the more the devil is going to trouble you. Uh-oh. Now, wait a minute. Some people would say, well, then, I shouldn't have got saved. Yes, you should have. Because the hell that you would have had to go through without the power is, oh, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. Why? Because Satan has no respect for you. Satan had no regard for you. And no matter how much filth that you experience out there in the world, Satan wanted you to get filthier. Hey, so salvation was your deliverance out of the hands of the devil. But listen, God wants all of his kids to know that when you came into the family of God, moreover, you took on power, you took on strength, you took on might, you took on purpose like never before. The problem is many of you don't know it, and you can't operate in what you don't know. So listen, I want you to know the enemy has been plotting against you. The enemy has perpetrated his dastardly plot against you, and he's gotten a lot of his henchmen on the take, and they have been assigned to destroy you. God told me to tell you, he cannot do it. Listen, I don't care how bad it gets. I don't care how ugly it looks. The devil cannot do it. Why? Because Jesus made a statement, and he said that the gates of hell shall not, come on, say it, shall not prevail against you. Listen, I'm going to take you through a lot of scripture, and we're going to make it. Luke 21:34 says, and take heed to yourself, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and the cares of this life. Many of you in here, you have not taken heed to yourselves because your heart is pounding like a storm on the inside of you, because you have allowed yourself to take on worry, fear, doubt, and unbelief. And the bad thing about it, I never could understand why these are traits of the devil, but we use those traits against God. Oh, yeah. So God told me, he said, tell my people, look, take heed. I want each and every one of you, look, hold up the mirror, and look at yourself. And I want you to realize that the reason you look the way you do, because you have taken on something that you had no business touching. Many of you are carrying weights that God did not equip you to be able to handle. And that's the reason why the storm is just raging all around you. That's The reason why you, everywhere you look like trouble is on every hand.